Adidas last year released the Adizero RC2 and the SL20, two great models which deserved an update in 2021. The RC3 and the SL20 version 2 are the brand new models we will compare in this video. So welcome back and enjoy. And here we are, guys. Welcome back to the channel. If you like the video, please leave a thumbs up and support the channel clicking the subscribe button here below. We are talking about two neutral shoes, but with some differences, starting for instance from the weight. To shortage the name, I will refer in this video to the SL20 as the SL20 version 2. The RC3 has a weight of 223 grams, 7.8 ounces in the US 10 sides. 213 grams, 7.5 ounces in the US 9 size, lighter than the Adios 5 and heavier than the Adizero Takumi. The SL20 has a weight of 247 grams, 8.7 ounces in the US 10 size for the male version, and 225 grams, 8 ounces in the US 9 size for the women version. So the RC3 is lighter than the SL20 and with an important difference of weight. Both shoes use the light strike foam in the midsole, in the entire midsole, and as we know, it is stiffer and more responsive in feel than the Boost foam. The RC3 is a low stackade shoe, 21.5 mm in the heel with 12 mm in the forefoot. Whereas the SL20 has a stackade of 21 mm in the heel and 12.5 mm in the forefoot. So basically, the new SL20 is lower than the previous one, and which has 15 mm stack, and a little bit lower than the RC3, and with the same drop of 9.5 mm. 0.5 less than the previous model. The light strike foam is really snappy, so it gives a nice feeling at a fast pace, but especially at the beginning when the shoe is new, it is really stiff, like cow horns. On the other end, I noticed that after 50 miles, the foam starts to be more comfortable, and in general, the stiffness of the foam ensures longer durability. Better than the Boost foam, which is softer. Both shoes have the same lower profile, not really carved or with a pronounced rocker in the forefoot. So they don't create a rolling motion, propel the foot forward and reduce the ankle flexion, decreasing energy consumption during running. A little bit better the RC3 in this regard due to the torsion system. In fact, the RC3 still has the torsion system which support and speed up the toe off, whereas in the SL20 it has been removed, and therefore I felt the RC3 snappier and with the heel to toe transition more responsive in feel than in the SL20. In regard to the drop, as we said, they both have a 9.5 mm drop, so they give a breathe to our calves. In the household, we have plenty of rubbers for both shoes, and the grip is good, but better in the SL20 due to the continental rubber and to the different patterns and rubbers used in the shoe, which improved the traction in every surface. Both shoes applied carvings in the rubber, which make the shoe more flexible, but in the SL20 there is more foam exposed than in the HRC3, which affect the durability. Regarding the upper, both have a new version of the upper. For the HRC3, the previous one become too loose soon after 50 miles, losing stability. For the SL20, the new upper doesn't have the room of the previous version, which is good. Both fit well, but the upper of the SL20 seems to be a little bit too tight, especially for long distance, it could be an issue. We will see in the 100 miles review. In terms of breathability, the upper of the RC3 is more breathable and even a bit looser than the upper of the SL20. Hopefully it won't be too loose like in the previous version after 50 miles. The tank in the RC3 is perfect with a nice padding in the right quantity. In the SL20 is thinner and with less padding, typical for such kind of shoes. Overall, I prefer the tank of the RC3 because more comfortable and longer than the tank in the SL20. Both have similar dimensions of the sole, except in the heel. The RC3 has a narrow heel, which is less stable in comparison with the SL20, especially for those who land in the heel, but at the same time allowed to consume less energy each stride. The laces are flat and traditional in both models, but I like more those one in the RC3 because larger. The lockdown system is traditional in the RC3 without any rings in nylon, and it gives me a feeling of longer durability than in the SL20. But then say that in the end, for which kind of training I would use the RC3 or the SL20? Well, basically the RC3 being snappier and lighter I would use for fast short workout like interval trainings and even on the track and field. The SL20 wants to be a tempo run shoes and probably it could be used for it, but it doesn't shine like other shoes for tempo run with a pronounced rocker in the forefoot, as for instance the Brooks Hyperion Tempo or the Evo Ride from Asics, which review links you can find up here. So guys, even for this week, this is it. I hope you like this video. If yes, don't forget to leave a thumbs up so I understand which kind of video you prefer, and consider to subscribe to support the channel and activate the notification bell so you won't miss any new video. Say that, as usual, thanks for watching and I'll see you soon in the next one.